Okay, we're going to continue doing some examples using the order of operations. So here's a problem. Now, when you do the order of operations, normally you look for anything in grouping symbols first, and there are no grouping symbols. And next you would do anything with exponents. And remember, you can either simplify that right off the bat, or you can change the exponents to a multiplication problem. So I'm going to do this both ways. All right, so if I do this 2 cubed here, one way is you copy up to that point, and 2 cubed is 8. Somebody else may have just changed it to 2 times 2 times 2. Either way is fine. All right, now, here's the next step that I usually do. If I just have multiplication and division and addition and or subtraction, you could do a little underlining technique where you underline everything except the plus or minus signs. And the reason this makes sense is that's the last thing you do is add or subtract. So I can do this, and I don't underline the plus sign, and this. It's almost if those are in grouping symbols. So I can do those independently. So if I do that, 14 divided by 2 is just 7, and 5 times 8 is 40, and that gives me my answer of 47. Same thing over here, 14 divided by 2 is 7, and then I have to multiply 5 times 2 times 2. You can go left or right. With multiplication, it doesn't matter how you do it. You can think of it as 10 times 4. I'm still going to get 40, so I get 47. All right, now it's actually true that without grouping symbols you could do this as well. So I could have done the 14 divided by 2 on the very first step. If I wanted, I could have underlined this and this right off the bat so that at this step here, instead of writing 14 divided by 2, I could have written 7, because you're still going to do your addition last. So that's up to you. It's a little bit easier if all there is multiplication and division. All right, here's another problem. Now, the first thing we want to do is look to see if there's any grouping symbols. In this case, there's the parentheses. So we want to simplify in parentheses first. So we've got 14 times. Now, you don't have to write the parentheses again because it's just going to be a single number. 3 plus 2 is 5. And now we need to go left to right because there's only multiplication and division, and with multiplication and division you go left to right. So 14 times 5 is 70, and then 70 divided by 10 is 7. If the division sign would have been first, you would have done the division first. It depends whatever comes first as you read it from left to right. All right, here's another problem. Let's go ahead and try this new grouping idea with the underlining. So I see a plus signs and minus signs. I underline everything up until I see a plus or minus sign. And then I continue underlining after it until I find another one through to the end of the problem. So if we do this, again, we can either write 3 squared and 2 squared as multiplications, or we could do the multiplication in our head. For this problem, I'm going to go ahead and do it in my head, because 3 squared, 3 times 3 is 9, and 2 squared is 4. And since this is underlined, I can go ahead and do this right now. 3 times 2 is 6. And since this is underlined, I could do the 20 divided by 5, which is 4. Now we're going to underline again, because there's still something to do there. Although these, there's nothing really to do, right? So I'm going to have 36 plus 6 minus 4. And now you go left to right, which is 42 minus 4. Or 38. In this problem, you may have just done the exponents first and just not done the underlining until the second step. So that's up to you, whatever you're more comfortable with. All right, here's another problem. Again, since there is something in parentheses, I usually like to go ahead and do that first before I do anything with the underlining. So we have 3 cubed minus 5. Now, there's a parenthesis. You can either write 5 and just parentheses 4, or remember, that means 5 times 4. 5 next to parentheses means you're going to multiply what that simplifies to. So this is really the same as 5 times 4. If you'd like to keep it in the parentheses, that's fine. It still means 5 times 4. And now we can go ahead with our little underlining technique. All right, 3 cubed. As a reminder, that does not mean 3 times 3. It means 3 times 3 times 3, right? Minus, let's go ahead and do these. Since it's underlined, 5 times 4 is 20. And 12 divided by 3 is 4. So let's do our little underlining technique again. So it's 27 minus 20 plus 4. All right, here's where you have to watch out. Do not add 20 and 4 together first. Since there's addition and subtraction, you need to do the operations from left to right once you get to just subtraction and addition. So I have to do the 27 minus 20, which is 7, and then add 4. You'll get the wrong answer if you first add 20 plus 4 and then subtract it from 27. You also get the wrong answer if you do 27 minus 5, way up at the top, look at the very top. If you do 27 minus 5 before multiplying by 4, you'll get the wrong answer. Remember, do order of operations, parentheses first, simplify that so it's just a number, then look for any exponents and do that. Then do look for any multiplication and division going left to right, and then any addition and subtraction from left to right. So when you're simplifying expressions using the order of operations where fractions are involved, you're going to have to simplify the numerator and denominator first. It's as if each is in parentheses. In other words, both the numerator and denominator were in parentheses. So here's an example. What if you had 14 minus 2 times 3 all over 12 minus 8? Even though you don't see any parentheses, it's like you have to simplify each of those first. You can't do any canceling or reducing until you simplify just the numerator and the denominator using the order of operations. All right, so you could do that on the side if you want. You could say, well, what is 14 minus 2 times 3? Well, that's 14 minus 6. Doing an order of operations, you're going to have to do this 2 times 3 first, correct? And that will give you 8, or you could write it up here, 14 minus 6, still going to get 8. And the bottom, 12 minus 8, that's easy to do, that's going to be 4. So we have 8 fourths, and what does that mean? That means 8 divided by 4, which is 2. So the answer to that problem is 2. Here's another one. Again, you have to simplify both the numerator and denominator using the order of operations. Now, you can go down the page. Some people prefer that. So I have to just concentrate in the numerator using the order of operations. So let's see. I've got subtraction and multiplication. Multiplication comes first. So I have 19 minus 12. And now let's look in the denominator. I'm going to have to simplify that. 5 squared, that means 5 times 5, which is 25. Okay? All right. We still have to simplify the numerator. 19 minus 12 is 7. And the denominator is 25. So our answer is simply a fraction. 12/25. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.